Everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I want to talk about what will be the consequence of this global crisis, coronavirus, what effect is gonna have on the industry and overall the market of programmers and engineers in general. So basically going forward, I mean all the jobs that I did, all my colleagues had at least a degree or PhD degrees, or they were professors. So you kind of need to be accepted in this corporate environment a degree. Everybody has it, and very few colleagues that I know don't have the degree, and they are managers most of the times, but or HR. Stuff like that. So for doing design, you probably need a degree. It is required by most of the companies, and I think that it's university in general and the education system is a bit inflationated, so it's way overvalued. In a sense that you can learn a lot of things online. And so I think going on in the future, more and more people we keep on start coding, because nobody likes to do, for instance, the plumber. Everybody has to code. And if your mindset is to just have a stable job, going on in the future, I don't think learning how to code is the best idea. I know a lot of my colleagues that have been laid off, very good and skilled engineers, because of economical reasons and stuff. So it happens to a lot of people in my profession to get laid off. So I don't think it gives you the stability overall. Right now that you see with the coronavirus, a lot of company laid off a lot of employees. And the coronavirus is gonna change the world, I think. And this is really an adjustment to what was a very overrated profession, in a sense, because a lot of the companies, especially startups, don't really solve any problem. They claim to be destructive and to take over the world. But in reality, what a business should do is construct and not disrupt things. So the idea is that we need to solve problems. Our job is to optimize society, solve somebody else's problem, so we can get somebody else fired. So you see that this is a very bad and vicious cycle that will keep on going. Our society is moving towards efficiency. It's amazing. I mean, if you consider what we have nowadays, especially I talk about the West, but I lived in China also. So you have, the banana that comes from Brazil, shipped, in Norway, and it doesn't cost much. So the supply chain, the transportation, and stuff, it's super super optimized. Another thing, in my industry we produce stuff at a nanometer scale, so very precise, very nice distribution chain testing, so in a sense it's amazing what we reached in terms of humanity and progress. But going forward, I think that the economic contribution that computers, automations gave is gonna fade off. It's important to see in history to predict the future. And industrial revolutions that we currently lived in, brought by PC, technology, internet and all the good stuff, that is gonna end sooner or later. So that whatever has to be built has been built, and we have services, everybody has phones, Everybody has information whenever they want, wherever they want. So that contribution right there should end soon. Of course, humanity will keep on improving, but I don't think it will be as steep as now. Economy will keep growing, I think, slowly, going on worse in the future. And the industry in general is gonna do very small improvements. So, as you see, for instance, I take an example, cars. Cars, yes, there are a lot of nice cars around, but everybody, almost everybody, that wants a car already has it, the same as with phone. And the improvement with models, the models don't improve as much as they did in the past, so they kind of now saturate. Yes, they include new features, but those are small improvements. It's not as radical as in the beginning. The same thing with phone, yes, battery life is improved. They put one camera, then the second one, then the third one, but in the end, I generally don't care much about those cameras. I know that there are a lot of phone enthusiasts, but my point is that phones also reach a bit of their, you know, stability. They, yes, are improving, but not as much. And the same for all other industries. So small improvement, not many disruptive industries going on in the future, and for sure there will be less of a need for coders or cheap designers, electrical engineers going on in the future. Of course, there will be the need. New products has to be made and designed, but it will not be as big of a boom like it was. And this coronavirus just adjusted the level of inflation, or like how many people are needed to do a job, or what is important. And a lot of businesses that are not technology related are suffering, but that's for other reasons. But for the tech industry, I think that there were a lot of people working on useless projects, companies that never saw a profit, that just have growth and investment. I mean, for me, if I was an investor, I would care about my return. I would like to see that my money goes into profitable companies. But apparently nowadays, everybody focuses on growth. And so we live in this should make you think about how inflated is technology and the industry in general. So thanks so much for watching, and see you in the next one.